That's a piece of flint mixed in with all this sandstone. You can always tell by the windows which way is out. So this would be an outer section, and this is the outside of the wall. This always had these angular designs so that arrows could be shot out in the event of a siege. Even though this is actually an abbey, but you know, medieval times. Stairs coming down. Stairs going back up. Just thinking, this would be a good spot to do some Shakespeare plays. They could use this big open area as a stage and then have seating around the outside. It's a shame there's not much left of this ruin. Thank you. So we walked in here, went around that way, along there, and just come back through here. So this is where we are right now. Last time I was up here, there's about a meter of snow. And the fox came within about 6 feet of me. This crossroads here, like I said last time, this came from there. I heard movement. It's middle of the night, there's lots of snow, and I had a torch. I saw a fox up there, so I turned the light on it. And he came wandering down. It's all the way down. Couldn't see me because of the torch light. Stopped about there. Got a whiff of me in the air and then took off. I see lots of birds around and I just saw a squirrel run across there. So let's see if I can get closer and find it. There he is. There he is. He's quick. He went up that tree, across, and it's on that branch. Now, unfortunately, my battery's running low, so I may not get much footage done, but I'm going to continue my walk. Okay, coming up to the area where I used to do a lot of testing or reviews of camping products when I was here last. What in the world is that supposed to be? Oh well. Looks like somebody's been trying to build a lean-to shelter. Holding it together with duct tape. Now let's see if I can find that spot. Yeah, the spot's down there somewhere. No way I'm going to get to it. That fern bracken's good 3 feet thick. Oh well. Back I go. This little clump of trees would make a good shelter in the middle here. I'm so surrounded by all these trees. So you put up some ropes, block off the sides. Even though it's on the hilltop, it can still work quite well. Alright, let's see if that works. Yeah, it should work. One of the first things that arrived in the post when I was here. Like when I arrived, was this. I purchased it from an English guy on a knife sales forum on Facebook. It was a small Finnish made camping bushcraft knife. That's the sheath. That's the blade. I'll get my ugly face out of the way. There's a stick tang going right through to the back where it's peened. A small guard and a small blade. And this thing is hair popping sharp. Needs a clean up, but I love it. Can't remember exactly how much I paid for it. Maybe about £25. It's really small though. So designed for a child. Or it's just a very small knife. So there you go. It's one of my first knives to be acquired inside the UK. Didn't think I was going to leave it behind, did you? Almost walked straight past this. Can't get any closer because there's a fence, but somebody has made art out of a dead tree stump. I'm going to try and zoom in, but I'm low on battery power, so I probably will not allow. I can see the signature, Tom Harvey, 2016. It's another tree stump artwork. Done by chainsaw by the looks of it. All right, off home.